The cliche, let's save the best for last, feels like the appropriate term for what is a highly anticipated final day of the NBA Academy Africa's tour to Angola. The multi-purpose arena in Kilamba has been the venue for all of the action and will continue to host today's game. Six straight days of competitive basketball will be capped off by another stern test for the elite roster. The NBA Academy Africa take on GD Interclub, and it should be a humdinger. And bringing you all of this action, Quinton Denason, I am alongside Mpumi Ramatsoha. And Mpumi, we've seen some fantastic basketball over the last 6 days, and the NBA Academy Africa team has certainly impressed with their tenacity, with their skill, what they've done on the floor, and now another test awaits.
Absolutely. They have been fantastic throughout this competition, and we've seen them grow in leaps and bounds in every single contest, and I expect nothing less here tonight against Interclub.
And when we talk about players that have impressed again, another standout performance when they took on Petro de Luanda yesterday. Aginaldo Neto, 19 points against his countrymen. And this Interclub team, they are runners-up in the Angolan League, the men's team. So that the club on the side of the ladies has a little bit more prestige, being African champions a whole five times. And the men trying to replicate this day is... no glory in the silver, but they certainly will bring some really interesting action to the floor. And this young Academy Africa team, as coach Karim Nesba has done in the past, he likes to keep his lineups relatively consistent. It'll be interesting to see how he goes out. We have Neto and Hindawi getting the start alongside Tiam Abbas and that man, Kaman Malwash.
Malwash has been a joy to watch play. We've seen him do it inside, we've seen him do it outside, particularly on the defensive end. All week long, we've seen him changing shots and even blocking some.
There's Lembe to contest alongside Churchill Abbas, and picked up by Francesco Gomez. Gomez quickly to the pocket. He gets the first two.
Inter will want to make sure they get going quite early. That would be a great start for them.
Neto, first offensive possession for Academy Africa. Abbas right into the action. And he's lined up against Lembe. Very similar looking frame. And it looks like it could be a matchup that you need to keep an eye on. Already, you can see just giving up a couple of inches on the inside, this Interclub team. Malwash, guarded by Tome. Looking for the pass out of the post, and they throw it away.
Yeah, just a little bit of just connect there on the offensive end for the NBA Academy Africa early on.
They're now been down. Neto applying pressure. Lembe. And the block comes from Malwash's. Timothy Chimalua drives on in.
And that's what I was talking about, Q. Malwash on the defensive end just has such great timing.
Yeah, fantastic work on that defensive coverage. And we have a look again at the awareness. Putting the ball on the floor, driving in, and there's that athleticism. Get that out of here.
And Hindawi leading him to the middle, almost knowing that Malwash is waiting on the inside.
Contact comes on the body, and so first trip to the charity stripe for Timothy Chimalua. Sprightly start for Interclub. Ball thrown away, fake, turn and go hook. Lembe, close range, can't finish. There's Malwash who comes in to clean up eventually. Now it's Neto. They need a score on this possession. Ball taken away, tapped away. Dundao drives into trouble. Abbas comes away with it. They have numbers now. Neto and Hindawi out on the break. Spills out.
Oh boy, what a tough start on the offensive end for the Academy tonight.
6 days of weary legs against another block. Malwash cleaning the glass, protecting the paint. Neto Churchill Abbas thinking about his options. Hindawi. Tiam has been starved of ball so far. Neto with the shot clock winding down. Hindawi's going to have to fire quickly. Long rebound. Nicely cleaned up by Lembe.
A couple of empty possessions on the offensive end for Academy. They're going to have to try and find their rhythm. Looks like they're trying to go inside.
Dindao. Long range shot comes. And this is absolutely everything. Well, quiet start. Guess can be expected. Like I said, it's 6 days in of really, really tough games back to back. And this team has been relentless. They keep getting better. Abbas on the catch and shoot, and he hits.
Ooh, stunning shot from Abbas from downtown.
It's Neto's baseline drive and then kick out to find the wide open shooter. And Abbas showing you that he's got a little bit more than a mid-range game. A drop off. Tomei cleaned away again. Malawash third block.
Man, Malawash has been fantastic to start this game.
Tiam has shown in transition just how really good he is, and it looks like he spills to the ground hard. There was some contact, and holding his, the back of his head, there will be some concern. We have seen a couple of injuries. You see Ulrich Chomche just dressed up. Saw him pick up an ankle injury in the game against the Akira Academy. He'll probably be out for this, the rest of this trip. Boy is out for the rest of this trip, and players do get some knocks occasionally.
Indeed, and they're going to try and have to keep most of these players healthy with the second season of the Basketball Africa League coming up. Of course, the majority of the academy falling on rosters as part of that NBA Elevate program.
Yeah, we'll try and call out as many as we know. With the Elevate draft happening, it's very important that we showcase where these young players will be as part of the 12 teams taking part in the BAL in season 3. Now the pass in. Tomei caught in trouble. Kicks out. Dundao, the long range shot is cleaned up on the rebound by Malawash. Quick pass ahead. And just the cry of frustration as Captain Gomez runs out.
It was a great defensive effort by Interclub there. We know that the transition game is a big component to this NBA Academy.
And now he turns. Fancy footwork goes left, then he gets the bucket to go.
Fantastic footwork from Hindawi.
Well, we haven't seen too much of that throughout this week from Hindawi. Must like the matchup. Goes into the footwork bag, steps through left hand glass, and it's all good.
Hindawi, of course, in the BAL, will be in the Nile Conference playing with the team from Angola, Pedro de Luanda.
He had a chance to see his teammates just an evening ago, and he gets the three-point play the old-school way. 8-3 the score. And we have 6:22 left in this first quarter. Tindao, Lembe. The drive in, Chimalua. Now Tindao goes behind the back, elbow jumper. Strong again. Malawash has been very active defensively. Another rebound.
That was some fantastic perimeter defense from Abyss early on in that possession.
And now Malawash calls for it. Hands off. Now Hindawi. Just around the screen, he pulls. Front iron. Malawash was right there on the coverage again, but Chimalua drawing the body contact. And good first 4 minutes holding this inter-club team to just 3 points for the Academy Africa.
I mean, they come out every game looking to absolutely try and dominate. And win or lose games, we know they leave it all on the floor.
Behind the back. A clean up. And now there's a scramble for it, and searching for this first bucket in the club. Drive in. Captain Gomes will go to his left-handed shot. Can't find it. Touch Maluwach, cleaned up by Abbas. Pass comes in. Tiam. Hindawi's got time and space. There is Maluwach, who knocks down the three ball.
He has had his handprints all over this game so far.
He has been everywhere, and getting an open look from the three-point line is something that he really favors and enjoys. So he knocks down another three and extends the lead to now 8 points. Driving, Gomez gets it back. Dundao will try his luck against Maluwach, who's been amazing so far. Gets it back again. Third chance opportunity here for Interclub.
And that's what I was talking about earlier, Q. If he doesn't block the shot, he at least alters it and makes it a tough one for the opposition.
Dundao, drop ball. Gomez this time gets the finish. Hassan Mandian is in. 16-year-old from Senegal for some minutes. But now the ball spilled. Lembe fakes. Dundao thinks about it, being forced to different options. A shot will come in, and they on the late on the cover is that Mandian commits the foul on Chimalua. And so that passage of play in favor of Inter. See Dundao break down off the dribble, the drop off, and extra bounce just to ensure the finish right there.
Much needed basket for Inter.
Brings us our first time out as NBA Academy Africa 11 and Interclub of Angola 5. Brightly start it has been for NBA Academy Africa. 11-5 the score, 3:51 left. Interclub have found it difficult inside the paint, and that's largely due to that 7-foot frame of Kamal Maluwach. And it's going to be not much easier for them as more changes come. Tahir is in place of Churchill Abbas.
Not enough can be said about the athleticism and the length of the players from the NBA Academy Africa squad.
Well, they continue to impress. Three free throws coming just before that timeout. Mandian, the guilty party. Maluwach will be picked up by AS Douan in BAL in season 3. And they, of course, out of Senegal. Mandian. Pass in. Obi drops off to Tiam.
I said at the beginning of the game, it looked like they were trying to go inside. There was a fantastic throw this time around. And Maluwach was finding the inside. Just unfortunate that they weren't able to finish.
Lembe drives. He goes glass, and there is Kamal Maluwach on the pickup. Mandian. The pass and the drop was picked up. Now they go back the other way. And the ball thrown out, spills out. Scrappy play by both teams on those last couple of possessions.
A little bit of turnover tennis.
I've heard that phrase somewhere before. 11-7 the score now. Inter starting to make some inroads in as the changes on the floor come. And obviously, substitutions can impact ebb and flow of the game. Get Maluash, Neto, Obi. Drives, he'll go to the runner. That strong ball is now spills loose. Chance for Inter to get out in transition. The drive. And that's a fantastic finish there by Captain Gomez.
And Maluash getting up in the air once again, but this time not able to block the shot.
Scoreless just in the last couple of minutes. This Academy Africa team looking short of ideas. There comes the shot. It's tad long, and then finally they get a finish on the inside. And that man Tahir will pick up his first score.
A little bit of a look what I found here, ending up with the ball right underneath the rim for an easy two.
Lembe, shot too strong. Maluash, another rebound. Neto, nice pass to the corner. Wide open shot, and it finally falls.
They will be finding some joy from the three-point line. Second one they've hit to begin this game.
Mandiana's had an impact moving the ball and also getting up the floor in a hurry. Nice positioning and also great court vision by Neto. Nonetheless, it's Inter basketball. Long range shot, strong and wide. Ndalibiwa, first touch of the basketball. Mandiana running, loses it. And there's some contact on it. Playing with some freedom. Hassan Mandiana looks comfortable, confident in his space on the floor.
He certainly is. Didn't quite play last night in the DNP against Petro de Luanda.
Recognizing the space, losing the ball, but it's Gomez is going to be called for the contact. Will not be taking part in the BAL in season three, Mandiam, but part of the larger picture. This is a staggered development program where you get 16 through 19 year olds, and the talent speaks for itself. Nonetheless, there comes Tahir away with it. Ball taken away. Sharp work by Gomez. Lembe right at Tahir. Great defense. Skying in is Obi for the board. Now we go back the other way. Neto. Tahir into the jump step sequence, and he gets the finish.
That was pretty as a picture, right through the defense, slices between them to get the lay-in.
Love the footwork, love the finish with the left hand. 18-9. Just broken that scoring run from Interclub. Gabriel Gomez seems to be like the primary option for this Inter outfit, and there's a shot clock violation as Inter run the offense a tad long and commit the turnover. Chance to NBA Africa to hold for the final shot of this first quarter. Neto. Course for the high screen, it comes. Mandiana will fire front iron, and that will bring a close to what has been a very, very well executed first quarter offensively by the Academy Africa team. It's 18 to NBA Academy Africa, 9 to Interclub of Angola, and we will have a short break and then right back into second quarter action.
What's happening in the new NBA app? What isn't happening?
Watch this.
Because this is can't stop, won't stop, oh, stop it. Being up to speed at the speed of...
Did you see that?
All access to all the above.
And that's all day.
Big stops, bigger shots, passes behind the back, to peaks behind the scenes, in every moment in between.
Because if it's happening...
It's happening in the new NBA app.
Second quarter about to get underway. Multi-purpose arena in Kilamba. And it has been NBA Academy Africa that have done all the early hard yards as they hold on to an 18-9 lead. Impressive play by Kaman Maluwash patrolling the paint in the first quarter. We saw some array of shooting, Mandian coming in. And they've really just done it hard on the defensive end, holding Interclub to 9 points in that first quarter. Mandian's shot.
Yeah, they've done a great job to keep Inter out of the paint. And they're going to have to look to try and knock down some shots, Inter, to bring that defense a little bit wider.
In comes Mabil, the 6'9 guard out of South Sudan as well. So it's Obi, Neto, Tahir, Mandian, and Mabil on the floor for NBA Academy Africa. Short on the runner. Tahir controls. Mandian drives, kicks. Mabil shot. Cleared out is Tahir. He gets the rebound and tries to go right back up. And right there is Ndalibiwa to throw it out.
It's great timing by Ndalibiwa. Looks like Interclub coming into the second quarter, looking to tighten up their defense.
Obi. It has to go into the runner, does Mandian, and that one is short, doesn't draw any iron, so shot clock violation.
First shot clock violation we've seen in the game so far.
Coach Karim Nesbar going a little bit different, and I think this is certainly because of the wear and tear on the legs of his starters and players that have been getting heavy minutes. So now a chance for the bench or the players who might not have seen some minutes to get the opportunity. Well, there's an easy two.
Yeah, and they are without the services of Captain Ruben Pinello today. We saw him on the bench during the timeout just in sequence.
Drive and drive in. And there is some contact on Mabil. See Mabil turn, drive in, draw a crowd, and there's Gomez probably going to be whistled for that one. Caught behind the action, and you know the grimace. That grimace of guilt is what we call it.
Absolutely, kind of an indicator to the referee that he knows it was him.
Neto, first shot from downtown is short. Now off to the races once again. Inter getting in transition. Good work by Obi.
And you can see the impact of that defense play in the first quarter. Making sure they have to fake before they go up. Just trying to have the defenders fly by.
Neto. Mabil. Tiam is back in. Obi. Shot selection is going to be questionable right now. That was well contested nonetheless. Dundao. Leonel Dundao. Setting up. Tome. Almost dispossessed by Tiam now. The Inter Club have numbers. Kick out to Dundao. Ball movement. Finds Gomez for the three from the elbow. That one is going to come off hard and go out.
We've seen a lot of contested jumpers. Mabil right in his face, outstretched arm contesting it.
Interesting phase of the game. Spilling to the floor. Favorable bounce, and oh my, spills the dunk. Tahir from close range couldn't finish. Now Gomez goes back the other way. Gomez lays up and in. Could almost feel the anticipation from Tahir, but he has no excuse. He should have finished from close range.
The Academy have just struggled to get going, yet to score here in the second quarter.
But Neto, commentator's blessing.
Must be.
19 in the loss against Petro, gets his first from downtown. Lead back up. 8 points. Dadao. Drop of pass. Short corner. And the jumper is good. Djungu. First two for him. 21 plays 15. On the pull-up, Neto goes glass. Tome is there to clean up.
Neto now putting up volume shots.
He is playing with a lot of freedom. Aguinaldo Neto blocked. Mabila goes to the left hand now. And there's just a lot more second chance opportunities for this Inter team. And there is Captain Gomez on the third chance.
Yeah, the academy's got to do a better job on the glass of boxing out and making sure they limit the second chance opportunities by Interclub.
Around the screen. Tiam beats one, loses it. Ball spills to the floor, and here we go. Gomez, sharp heads up play. The fake. Incoming Tahir trying to block it, and then somehow back the other way. Neto, four defenders around him, finds Tiam. Fakes and getting a call for the travel.
Yeah, just a little too quick by Tiam there.
Well, the best way to try and capture that in words is just scrappy.
It has been a little bit of a scrappy stretch that we've seen here from both teams, coupled with turnovers and some wide open missed
shots, turnovers, some defense, and definitely intensity, and that'll bring a timeout on the floor. 21 plays 17, and we've got 5:34 left here in the second quarter. One of the statements from yesterday's game is it's not about the win, it's about the growth. And I think that's a fantastic way to approach, and a fantastic approach to the game for this NBA Academy Africa young team. They don't always have to win every game, but they definitely take the lessons from all of it. But nonetheless, 21-17, they are in the lead.
And what you love to see too is that they compete in every single game. And that's really what's important about this club.
Competing, not participating, and continuing to just grow and develop as basketball players and as men. The drive in, Gomez goes left, goes right hand rather. Nabil, Obi, the extra pass to Neto. Can't get it, and it's Tiam on the finish.
Great cleanup by Tiam.
Gomez contested. There's a pass, nice rebound. Gomez wants the foul for the referees, look the other way. Tiam. Rhythm dribble. It was a very relaxed shot. Could have gone in.
It was actually a great decision. They left him alone there on the three-point line. A little bit of time, a little bit of space. We always say that's just what a shooter needs, and so he took his shot.
Sure did. Just lead back at 6 points. In comes Maluwash, now going with the starting lineup. Maluwash and Abbas back in. Neto. Neto. Obi. Maluwash fires the three, back iron. The drive and the finish. Oh my. Ndalibiwa flushes it down with the left hand.
He knew Maluwash was chasing him down, and so he knew he had to flush that one.
Maluwash. Found it close. And you've got to be wary of some foul trouble here. Inter, they are running a limited rotation, and there's that throw down. Ndalibiwa. It's the use of the rim as well, just to protect for the defense coming behind. If they had any thoughts of trying to block him, he used the rim to make sure that there's no chance that the throwdown doesn't happen.
Yeah, he was definitely aware of that long frame of Maluwash that was chasing him down.
Quick shot. Obi misses everything. There's Abbas hanging. Taken away by Tiam. This is a third chance opportunity now, and they don't get the shot up because shot clock doesn't reset. laces the bottom of the net, but Tia does Tiam, but it's too little, too late. Small margins, Zendawi back in. Zendawi just a little bit ahead of the play. Now Inter just trying to figure out a way to get through this Academy Africa wall. Shot clock winds down and Dalibiwa is forced to shoot. Stepped by Maluwash, good read by Tome to secure possession back. There's Dendao.
Again, the NBA Academy giving up some rebounds and allowing second and third chance opportunities here.
Cleaning up on the board again, Kaman Maluwash on the Dendao miss. Drive in, left hand, beautiful move by Tiam.
Pretty as a picture. Tiam going straight down, an easy layup.
Now it's Tim Dow. Drive in. Well, we have seen Ndalibiwa is fearless. He is certain about his movements and his motions, and he's got the athleticism to match all of that bravery and courage.
I think we've seen that from this entire NBA Academy Africa roster here. They just go into every game and they go hard and they go at these professional players from other clubs with no fear.
Well, that'll be what free throw line. He gets both. The buzzer sounds. Substitutions as Captain Gomez, or rather Mario Tome, takes a break. Ndawi. The drive is Ndalibiwa once again tapped away. Maluwash secures possession. Tiam! And man, does he love the open floor.
It's almost like he glides through the air on those ones.
Ndalibiwa hits the bottom of the net on that, providing some spark for Inter off the bench for sure. Almost thrown away. Maluwash goes through the legs. It's great ball pressure now. Secures the turnover. Dalibiwa hit one. Wouldn't have bet on him missing that. Now there's more contest underneath, and there's Njugu right there in between the trees drawing the foul.
I mean, considering the numbers they had taking that seemingly fast break three-point shot, seems like a bit of a heat check after having hit one before.
Same spot. Can't blame him for trying to take that shot. Danger time just a little bit for Academy team. On the second make, can be back within one here. Inter, who have been steady. They've been buoyed by the introduction of Ndalibiwa. He's given them just a little something on the offensive end.
Yeah, Inter definitely have chipped away at this lead. And will probably look to take a lead themselves going into halftime.
And Leanne throws away. Abbas does tap back. Now the ball is pushed up. Tiam. Neto thought about it. Goes behind the back and then draws the foul.
Coach yelling from the bench to pass the ball.
Coach Karim Nesba has been superb. You can just see the respect his players have for him. And the understanding. There's the floater. Mandian can't find his touch. Comes off and goes straight out of bounds.
And of course, through the improvement of these players is a testament to him and his squad and the work that they've been able to produce with them.
Coach Roland Houston overseeing the program. Passionate, passionate individuals when it comes to the game of basketball.
And to the development of the next generation of players coming out of the continent.
And I was looking around and feeling a little frustrated. He spins and gets by Neto. Neto reaching from behind. Nice turn of speed for Leonardo Ndao. You don't want to get one of two. Chance to tie it up as we get closer to the half. Well, we're tied at 27. Maybe some consternation on the face of Coach Karim Nesba. And yet, Malawash wasn't quite ready. Turnover.
Yeah, not sure what the call was there. But it certainly was a turnover for the academy.
Dalbiwa knocks down another three. Man, he's got the hot hand.
And the momentum has all been the way of Interclubs here in the second quarter.
10 points already in this second quarter. Malawash spins baseline, draws the contact. 41 seconds, all that remains in the second quarter. Inter found some rhythm offensively. Come on, Malawash. Chance now at the charity stripe. He's been certainly one of the players that we've kept an eye on. The 7'1", 238-pound prospect. He's gained over 30 pounds while adding an extra 5 inches to his vertical in his time at the academy.
That is certainly impressive.
Last couple of possessions, one would think, for both these teams. 35 seconds. Dispossessed. Malawash. Chance here for Academy. Oh, my! Almost threw it down. That was fantastic awareness by Tiam. Now back the other way they come. Looking for the highlight play. Game clock winding down. Neto Hezies drives in. And there's the contact.
Man, oh man, that was almost a poster from Tiam.
Tiam, out of nowhere, just decided that that was the option he wanted to take in. Recognizing where the defense was. Oh my, my. I wanted him to finish that. I did. Dalipiwa gave Malawash a poster a little bit old earlier on. Maybe Tiam looking for a little bit of revenge of his own.
I mean, I don't expect the game to end without us seeing at least one poster from the NBA Academy Africa team.
One? Just one? We wait and see. 29 plays 30. 12.9 left. Ties it up. Chance for Inter to just take some momentum into the half. They've managed to tie this one up. To being down as much as 10. There's Dundao off the dribble, front eye, and Abbas guys to just secure the rebound. And that's the way that this half will come to an end. And it's been 20 minutes of some really enthralling basketball. And at the end of the second quarter, it's NBA Academy Africa 30, Interclub 30. We have 20 more minutes of great basketball to bring you as this Academy Africa tour comes to an end.
I'm very thrilled about the fact that we're now opening the first NBA store on the continent of Africa this month in Johannesburg. It's been a long time coming. Part of our ambition for growing the game on the continent is to grow the engagement with our fans.
The idea about the store is to create a premium, first of its type, on the African continent to deliver apparel, footwear, NBA merchandise to our consumer.
We just felt we wanted to create a space that is uniquely African, that celebrates our players. It's unmistakably the NBA, but that's something that can evolve over time.
It should be a place where our fans are able to get closer to the NBA experience.
So as you walk in, we want you to feel really small in the sea of product. So it's cool music, it's lots of visuals, it's lots of movement, and it's lots of color. We definitely want to create an experiential environment for our consumer to keep them engaged, to keep them wanting to come back to the space.
I think everybody's going to be very excited when they come in, they see this wall of Nike, and then they see the wall of Mitch and Ness, and then, you know, this massive Nero display. It's really just going to give us size and scale, and I think an excitement that that everybody's been waiting for.
So we're going to have 30 teams displayed in our space, and the e-commerce site will be able to DHL anywhere on this continent.
We're going to have more range and more things available in our store than we've ever had in South Africa, and certainly across Africa up until this point.
Our ambition is to open other stores in South Africa and eventually other stores around the continent, because our fans are present all across the continent and we want to bring this special experience close to as many of them as possible.
The NBA Academy Africa is special.
This trip in particular gives us a chance to come down here to South Africa. One of the things we try to do at the Academy is stress the fact that it's a growth and development program, how our guys are learning and growing from all the great things that we've been doing since we've been here.
It's a big office. I was very happy seeing the statues, the ones for the height. Seeing all that stuff in the office, the balls, the jerseys.
I'll be very proud to see my jersey at the office in the box like this.
That was a great experience.
A young man in Africa can have a predictable pathway from grassroots, learning to play the game the right way, all the way to professional without leaving the continent.
And you went to the museum, it was very emotional. But it was good too for me to learn what Mandela did for this country and for Africa.
You ready?
Yes, sir. I'm ready, 100% ready. Born ready.
If we are all together, we did everything right, of course we will need it.
We all know the reason why we are here, and we all know that we can do this.
We're going to give everything and do everything we can. 1, 2, 3, 4!
So the halftime break is over and we are about to get underway here in the third quarter. The game is tied at 30 and it has been fascinating viewing for sure. The Academy Africa team going up early and then Inter fighting their way back. And it really was the introduction of Ndalibiwa, who's right there picking up the foul that made the difference for Inter in the game.
He made a fantastic difference in that second quarter, Q. However, for the Academy Africa team, they've got to limit those turnovers. 16 turnovers in the first half after having just 21 total in the game last night against Petro de Luanda.
Taking care of the basketball, very, very crucial. And one thing that Academy Africa does is that they spread the floor and they spread the scoring. And that'll be what, 11th point. He has put up 13 shots already from the field and converts on that for 12 total points. 2-point lead. And fascinating 9 minutes that should be ahead of us. Malouash, Neto, Abbas, Ndawi, and Tiam, the same starting five that came out for Coach Nespa.
In the game, they start out with a turnover on that possession.
Inter. Lembe. Gomez back, the captain. Hassled by Tiam. Ball is dispossessed now. Neto out in the open floor. Gets into his stride and he gets the finish.
Superb work by Neto to get that steal and finish. Looks to be grimacing though on the floor.
He went to ground hard, did Aldenado Neto. Maybe some concern there for sure. Gets the hand on the ball from Lembe and then Dindao could not get there. And trundling into him as Lembe comes through late. And that could have been dangerous.
Could have indeed. Thank goodness he's okay. Gets to his feet and heads the line.
Completes the three-point play the old school way. Has been great this Tome. Dow cleaned out by Abbas.
Great timing from Abbas, getting all the way in the air, meeting that shot at its apex and sending it to the stands.
Volleyball spike. Dindao. Tome. Ndalibiwa drives in. It spins out. Well contested defensively. Just couldn't get the finish.
A good hustle from the Academy to try and hold on to that rebound. Unfortunately, though, Abbas ends up out of bounds.
Tomei, Dindao. Lembe had the seal on Abbas. That's a strong big man move. Couldn't finish. Got all the way in front of the rim and again, well contested by Malouash. Neto throws up and Tiam comes down. Fantastic lob. And the athleticism of Tiam on the fast break in full effect.
Great find there by Neto. You see him out in transition, recognizing where Tiam is and putting it up in the air. You need to throw it down.
Two fantastic high flying points, and it's the point guard play from Neto, the vision, and then you just see jumping like it's off a trampoline and setting the offensive tone for sure. Lembe likes that matchup, gets it back. Unforced errors, and Ndalibiwa can't hold.
And it seems in the third quarter, it's Inter who pick up all the turnovers.
Much better start in terms of ball possession and carrying and taking care of the basketball for Academy Africa. Saying that, they turn over again now.
Commentator's curse.
Gomez, not there. Small watch on the conscious. Tiam and Gomez tangled up on the floor. Looks like it's going to be Inter basketball.
Yeah, I think the foul went against Tiam. you're just getting tangled up there trying to gain possession of the ball.
Now, a little bit of scoreboard pressure on both these teams. Just have to make sure that they value possessions. We've seen quite a few shot attempts from Inter to start out the second half. They haven't been converting at a high percentage. Nice pass in. Malawash got a touch on. It should have been goaltending, but they got the bucket nonetheless. Tomei cuts quickly for the second of his field goal. 4 points. Ndawi. Bad options. Steps out. Another turnover.
Coach is only going to be happy with the amount of turnover that this team accumulated in this game.
Tomei. Gotta be one. Hand off to Bundao. Lembe is calling for it on the inside. It's not seen. Bundao, 3 seconds left on the shot clock. He hangs. It's taken away. Another great defensive possession now. Chance for Neto. Ndawi is in the corner. He shoots the three, front iron. Back the other way. Drop off pass. Gomez! He went up high and hard. Abbas was there to try and block him. There's Abbas again on the block. Three ball comes in. Malawash controls. A three-bound of the game.
I mean, between Malawash and Abbas on the inside, it is tough going at the rim.
Quick shot again, and we have to look at the shot selection right now from this young team. Drop off. Tomei fakes twice. Nembe catches, shoots, and there's the back iron. And there's some off the ball contact.
Yeah, Malawash trying to say to the referee that he's holding him there. But he gets caught for the push in the back.
Mario Tomei goes to ground. A little bit of a sell. Little bit of a sell. That's what veteran players do. See the situation and embellish and make sure the referees see what's happening. Neto reads the pass well. Into the path of Malawash. So Malawash will get waved off. Call for the travel.
Yeah, it looked like he just barreled into the body there. Took a little extra step.
It was almost a spectacular play. A 7-footer in full flight on the fast break. Just couldn't get the finish. 1 point game still. Tomei. Giving a little bit of room back. Malawash. Dalibiwa. Call for the travel.
Again, another turnover. This time it's the way of Interclub.
Aginaldo Neto. Dispossessed now. A chance for Inter in transition. Abbas is there to contest. Chimalua is there. Abbas walks away as if to say, give me the space. I need some time to think about this.
There was definitely a lot of contact on that take, Hugh.
So physical. Chimalua wanted the unsportsmanlike and the hold, but he'll have to settle for two from the charity stripe. Inter have only led by as much as 3 points in this one. One of two from the free throw line. Been as much as 9 up for Academy Africa.
And all of Timoloa's points have come from the line too. He is now 4 of 7.
Timoloa fires in front eye. There's another big board for Malawash. 9th rebound. Neto. goes through the left hander. Everything was good about that move, just couldn't get the finish. And there's a Gomez on the run. Well contested.
The pace of this game picking up a little bit now. Both teams looking to run.
And yeah, back in. There's a shot that comes in. Dalibua. Wild shots on both sides. We are getting free flowing offense. Best way to look at this one. Corner three. And finally, Mandian knocks one down.
That was the third transition three we'd seen in play. This one, though, ending in a bucket.
Nice ball movement. The rebounding has been great. And this was, again, the vision of Neto selling everything like he's going middle and nothing but net on the shot from Mandian, and off the ball contact called. Will be inter-club basketball. Three does count. Ando. Chimalua. Dalibiko. Blocked. Another one from Maluach.
There's a lot of action happening underneath the rim.
Neto finishes. Wow, that's just great. Difficult to time that one for the defense because you're not sure if he's going front side. And just shows his experience in transition. Baseline drive. Elbow jumper is good. Tomei using the fake effectively to create space, and he gets the shot up for two.
Yeah, great job by Tomei to use that fake to get Maluash up in the air and create some space for his jump shot.
Well, after that whole frenetic freestyle passage of play, we have a timeout, and it's NBA Academy Africa 40, Inter 37. 3:54 left. Three-point game as the NBA Academy Africa wrestle to keep the lead ahead of this experienced inter-club team. It's been well contested, both teams jostling, and it has been transition-style basketball, the best way to describe it. And now it is Academy's basketball. Neto. Foul comes in. That's Njungu. Whistle for the infringement.
Njungu a little overzealous there as they try to double team. Reaching in and picks up the foul.
Back in Mandian. Mandian has some space. It opens up and he flushes it down. Wow.
Way to throw it down.
Like the Red Sea's parted, Mandian made sure that he read from the Bible verse dunk. Ball goes inside. Now baseline spin is no good. Njungu out of control on that one. Now Neto. Left hand pass. Dair, great positioning, and that is some great offense.
Yeah, the NBA Academy Africa team beginning to settle in now on the offensive end, finding some good spots.
Tomei. The momentum now clearly on the side of Academy Africa. Drive in. Again, a little bit out of control. Jemez. This is controlled. Neto. Been great with his selection. And the drive is Tiam inside.
Tiam rising above the defenders. Put that one in.
Tiam will leave you guessing. You never know if he's going to finish left or right. He has the ability to switch in the air, and he's just so athletic. Down on the ground goes Denisio Njungu. Couldn't see what happened, just off the ball. And this is that drive in. Mandian flying through the air. Vince Carter-like for the slam. Say it again from the Gospel of Dunk as he throws it down. Time out on the floor just as we took in that fantastic high-flying action. Jungu looks like he's struggling, so he'll head to the bench and probably have that scene too. 9-point game back to the largest lead of the game for the NBA Academy Africa squad. Step back, Gomez. Leans in, couldn't find his touch, and the rebound is controlled again. Nice little scoop pass. Tome up and over. Wow. Sub touch.
Great job to get that over the outstretched arm of Maluan.
Not easy task to get it up over that 7-foot frame and that wingspan, but that was dipped up its indeed, and that just came from the drop off of Gomez, the use of the rim, and the timing over the two trees inside the paint. Basket is waved off. Holding foul. He'll be on the ground, so Academy to inbound. 1:45 left in this one in the third quarter. This is definitely the best unit when Maluasha and Abaso on the floor for the Academy team, but that ball thrown away. Drive is finished. Willed it in, did Gomez.
Fantastic acrobatic finish from Gomez.
Neto draws contact of his own. And talking about a unit, you gotta have Neto at the point guard. Decision making and his scoring threat is tangible. Neto will take a break, and Dawi back in. That was a turnover. Neto losing the ball on the way up.
Neto's a great facilitator for his team. Really sets the tempo.
Drive. Thrown out. Tome combining with Jimenez. Back out to Tome. Big baseline hook shot is nice. Can get his first bucket of this one.
Well there with a multitude of moves to get the bucket.
Tiamo short the three, and Ndawi was right there to contest the rebound. Last touch ruled off Ndawi, so Inter basketball. 57 seconds. Tome. Shot from Jemez. Cleaned up.
Inter really have not had much joy beyond the arc. Going just 2 of 14 in the first half. Shooting it at just 14.3%.
Coach running his bench for Inter. Hebo in for his first minute. There's Ndawi around the Abbas screen. Contact again. Haven't seen too many touch fouls, contact fouls. No teams in the penalty area in the third. It's been relatively free-flowing. Can't imagine that, given the scoreline, the fourth quarter might tighten up just a little bit.
Yeah, I think you can definitely expect things to be played a little bit tighter going into the fourth quarter, with the Academy holding on to a very narrow three-point lead.
And Dawi, there's got quite a bit of interest around him. He will be playing for Petro in the BAL season 3, but as part of the Utah Games G League Showcase, BAL Showcase and the Road to the Basketball Africa League, BWB Africa, and then under 18 Egyptian team. So Pac-12 interest as far as US colleges are concerned. Thrown away now. Yeah, chance again in transition, and Tiam knows what to do with it out there in the open court.
Once again, Tiam just gliding through the air out in transition for an easy layup.
He is a terror on the fast break for sure. Final 3 seconds. Shot comes well timed by Tiam on the block. Heads up play by Jimenez, and he just can't get it to go. But the NBA Academy Africa team extend their lead to 7 points after being tied at the half. So at the end of three, it's NBA Academy Africa 50, Interclub 43.
In the new NBA app, what isn't happening?
Watch this.
Because this is can't stop, won't stop, oh, stop it. Being up to speed at the speed of...
Did you see that?
All access to all the above.
And that's all day.
Big stops, bigger shots, passes behind the back, to peaks behind the scenes, in every moment in between.
Because if it's happening...
It's happening in the new NBA app.
Fourth and final quarter about to get underway. This is, of course, coming to you from Multi-Purpose Arena in Kilamba. It's been the venue for all of the Academy Africa's games, and they've seen different opponents. This is their final one, GD Interclub. And as things currently stand, it's a 7-point lead that the Academy Africa team hold on to. 50-43, final 10 minutes. Neto, Ndawi Abbas, Tahir, Mandian on the floor for the NBA Academy, and there's a nice suck that's finish inside to get things underway and lead back up to 9, and Ndawi finishes for 2.
Yeah, Ndawi just going right at the body of the defense and putting it up.
We haven't seen too much of him.
Yeah, we also haven't seen very much variation in terms of the defense of either of these teams. You know, over the past couple of days, we've seen teams employ different defenses against this team and struggle. Most of this game, we've seen just a man-to-man from both sides.
I am a firm believer in that old mantra, if it ain't broken, don't fix it. And they don't have to do too much. You have to manage the scoreline, and what they've done so far, I think, suggests that they've pushed when they needed to. But nonetheless, here we go, back with the action. Neto, deep three. Again, and Ndawi in the wall, cleaned up by Ndalibiwa. Chimalua. Breaks down the D, he hangs for a second, it drops off. Lembe shot, and he went glass, but just couldn't get the finish. It's a bit too flat.
It's a little intimidating going in there with all those trees, Q.
It is not just a little intimidating, it's very intimidating. Neto. Away from the screen. Ndawi spins. Got caught in trouble, and yep. Got on his back. Called for the travel.
Yeah.
Three possession game is what it is. This team. And that is another quick turnover by Chimalua. Tries to force the pace in the tempo.
They've got to take better care of the ball if they're going to get this lead down.
Abbas skies up on the miss from Tahir, and he finishes right up above the rim. Largest lead of the game, up to 11. 54 plays 43.
First double-digit lead we've seen all game from either team.
Chimalua. Used the screen while he gets jammed by the rim. Just misjudged the layup.
Such a fantastic cross to lose the defense and get there. And just was not able to finish.
Sometimes it's just losing a little bit of gas, misjudging. But nonetheless, results in another turnover and a chance for Academy Africa to extend this already significant lead. Malawash back here. And Dawi spills to the ground, and that is frustrating, sure, for Coach Karim Nespa. Just doesn't go to hand.
Yeah, and as we've seen, like I said, a lot more turnovers from this team tonight than we have in the past couple of days.
Taken away. Tiam ahead of everyone. Tiam up, and Dale Bigwa from behind. And that is a little bit dangerous. Tiam went to ground hard. He seems to be okay.
Seems to be having a bit of a smile.
Maybe just a little bit of time. And this again, great work defensively. Tiam steals the basketball, gets out ahead. Timing. And yeah, clear foul. He tried to time the tomahawk from Tiam, but got nothing but his arm. It's ruled unsportsmanlike.
I mean, like you said, it does appear to be a bit of a dangerous play, and so it's a fair call to have it called unsportsmanlike.
Well, we talked about players that you see steadily improving in front of your eyes. Tiam is definitely another one of those. His go-to game is his speed up and down the floor, and great exponent of the transition game. He misses both. Great physical skills, and he can't finish through contact. Wasn't part of the All-Star team in the Basketball Without Borders Global Showcase. There's Abbas on the turnaround. Tiam challenges, and there's last touch of Inter.
Nice display of footwork there from Abbas. Pretty shot, couldn't make it, but position remains with the Academy.
Pass was there, but ball goes back out.
Missed opportunity underneath the rim. Abbas was wide open on that inbound.
Abbas turns in, gets it back somehow. There's just so much contact happening up in there. Painted area. The physicality seems to have increased just a little bit here in the fourth quarter.
To be expected, considering the scoreline of the game. You know, 11 points, still quite close and attainable for this Interclub team.
Will be part of the BAL showcase. U.S. Monaster picking him up. And that should be a fascinating addition to the reigning BAL champions. Again, another all-star in the BWB Global Showcase. He's got offers from the University of Mississippi, Arizona State, Memphis, Nebraska, and Xavier. Getting lots and lots of attention is Churchill Abbas.
Those are some impressive students, man.
He's an impressive player.
Indeed.
Dindao. Drop a pass. Domei with nowhere to go. He'll pull. with the shot clock winding down, Fran Dyan, second chance opportunity, cuts into space, and that's a heads up play. Smart, good finish. Kingidi, play provider.
Nice pass there from Kingidi to find the cutter.
Oh my! 36 inches of vertical right there for the two-hand flush.
A bus going all the way above the rim.
Credit to Yam for the feed. 12-point game. Bintao fires. That'll be double-digit rebounds from Alwash. Ball spit ahead. Yam into his jab step routine. He manages to keep alive, but then spills out of bounds. Another look at the pass in and the finish by Tomei. And with 5:52 left, we have a timeout called on the floor. It's NBA Academy 57 and Interclub 45. Another look at that fantastic finish by Abbas, which took us to the timeout, and now we're back in. 57-45, we've got 5:46 left in this one.
And it has been a banger. I expect the last 5 minutes to be just as exciting as the rest of the game.
Ngidi. Again on the return pass. Couldn't hold it, it's taken away by Neto. Tiam. Has Ndawi ahead of him. Season. And there's Ndawi on the finish. Nice. Second assist.
Nice finish from Ndawi there. Nice base cut.
Better pass from Tiam.
Indeed, fantastic recognition from Tiam.
Hanging. Blocked. Ndawi met by Ndawi. Now it's Maluwash again in the center of the paint. Can't finish, but keeps the rebound alive. Extra pass, and Dawi steps into the three.
And that's been back-to-back-to-back fantastic play from Hindawi. First the layup, then the block shot on the other end, and then comes and hits a three to add to the tally of the Academy team.
Cristiano, first minute, there's Tomei just inside. Credit him for that long two. Luas sets the screen for Tiam. Wants it on the post. Upset feeds right back. Tiam out of control. How did he get that in there? My.
I mean, Tiam really knows how to find the rim. He was falling out of bounds almost and still managed to get the two.
We've seen an array of his skill set. It's thrown up, talking about array of skill, and it's finished again this time. The nest just dropped in. No need for the extra flourish.
Young has been spectacular throughout this game.
It has been a showcase of his offensive skill set. And there he is on the rebound again. Neto. Options. Abbas! Two-handed thunder jam. I don't know what you want to do with that.
He just put it on the floor, one dribble, get by that defender, and down once again is a bust.
Well, they are now starting to run away with it. NBA Academy Africa lead up to 21 points. 3 minutes left. You can start to think about that trip home as far as the young kids are concerned. But they got to play all 3 minutes. Back it comes, and Dawit jabbing into the zone. Go into the club. Abbas drives through the contact, count the bucket, and one.
Acrobatic move from Abbas, hanging in the air, and gets the finish.
He's attacked the rim hard, but also showed that once he puts the ball on the floor, has the agility, the skill, the speed, also the strength to play through contact, and then he gets another one. Certainly, the player that you got to keep an eye on is Churchill Abbas. 6'8", 243 is the physical stats around him.
And he'll be one of those that will be making a college decision soon, Q, considering he is the class of 2023.
Out another Nigerian national. And he back irons on the free throw. Can't get the full 3-point play. Contact call. And just another look at this Academy Africa team. And Churchill Abbas. That almost becoming like a trademark dunk.
Absolutely.
In full flight. Three-pointer, a bit long, it's cleaned up. People scooped up and in as easy as you like.
And the Academy team are definitely rolling now, too.
They sure are. Hook is good. Cristiano. Mabil. Rebound by Obi. Now going with more of his bench options, coach Karim Nesba. Mandian knocks down the three ball again.
Fantastic shot from Mandian. He's been sitting a while. It comes in scorching from 3-point line.
Lead extended. Turn around shot, face up jumper rather. Long, Neto, Hezi. Ball fake, out Mandian. Can't hold cleanly, so we'll reset the offense. Driving in, taken away. And you can hear the cry of frustration as Lionel Hebo just could not control trying to get the transition opportunity back of his own. 102, all that's left in this one.
Definitely some frustration from Inter here in the final quarter. Just allowing the Academy team to put up a lot more points than they have the rest of the game.
Neto will fire. Rims up and over and will be Interclub basketball. Well, we've been treated to a real showcase of this NBA Academy Africa team's depth and just the level of talent that they have at each position.
It has been a fantastic tour to Angola. They've had so many opportunities to showcase their talents against various teams and various levels of competition.
Also different styles of basketball, and no better place to test it than the land where 11 championships have existed on the continent, and with some of the most prestigious clubs continental. There's Bandian in the corner again. Seconds now. I think it's been a successful tour.
It does appear to have been a successful tour. You know, we've seen each of these young men grow as the tour has gone on. And what a way to cap it off for this NBA Academy Africa team.
Nothing like going home with the win. You know, I spoke a little bit earlier about the mentality of this team. It's not about winning, it's about growing, but you can also grow with a little bit of success, and here they are picking up a win over Interclub. Significant, credible performances by Tiam, Malwash, Abbas, Neto. It was a great showcase of what the depth and breadth of this roster looks like, and also tough games back to back. And this team has been relentless. They keep getting better. Abbas on the catch and shoot, and he hits. Ooh.
Stunning shot from a bus from downtown. Nice pass there for Steve to find the cutter.
Oh my! 36 inches of vertical right there for the two-hand flush. Really been a great venue for all of the action. And at the end of this one, Mr. Pumi Ramatoka, it is NBA Academy 75, Interclub of Angola 49.